I'm delighted to be with you here again today. It's a great joy that I feel in my heart. It's Mentor Ote, and I have a question for you. My question is this: how would you spend your entire day if money was no object? If you were financially free, if you had no burdens, and you could live your life the way you wanted, doing what you want, with whom you want, how would you spend your day? Now let me share a picture of what my day looks like, and I'll share some of the ideas and the philosophies that have made a difference in my life. I think it will make a difference in your life too as well. So stay tuned. Now, for you to understand the context of what I want to share with you, it's important you have an idea about who I am and some of my history. You see, I was able to achieve financial freedom within an 8-year period. I come from very humble beginnings. I was raised financially destitute. I was raised by two great parents, an amazing mother and a fantastic father. We were spiritually rich. We had the right attitude. We had gratitude. We had the philosophies of abundance and joy and happiness. But we lacked the intelligence about how to create wealth. And for that reason, we were financially destitute. And so, during my upbringing and my childhood days, there were moments when having two meals in a day was worthy of celebration. And I remember it like though it was yesterday, because it wasn't simply a negative experience. In a very interesting way, as a young child, you still find a way to be happy. And if you haven't been exposed to wealth, then you really don't know what poverty is. What I mean by that is, if your environment is poor, then one of the things we tend to do as human beings is compare ourselves to the people around us. And if the people around you are in the same circumstances that you are, then you don't see yourself as being any different. But I was exposed to a different life. And the exposure I had developed into a passion, a desire in me for a better life. You see, I like what one great author said. He said, "A mind expanded beyond its original dimension to a new place of discovery never returns back to where it used to be." And that is exactly what happened to me. I came in contact with other people who were living a life that I admired and something that I wanted, and that stirred up a passion and a desire in me. I immigrated from my place and country of birth. I came all the way to London, England, in pursuit of a dream. I had nothing, I knew no one, but I had a dream. And in so many cases, all you need is to give yourself the permission to dream, and then believe that you can make that dream a reality. Upon arriving, I fell into very difficult times. I was in debt, I was unhappy, I had no support around me, but I had a dream. And 8 years after that period, after arriving, I was financially free. Now the question is, how can some poor young African boy immigrate all the way to a different continent where he knows no one, where he has no access to resources, and in 8 years, he achieves financial freedom? That is a question I want you to ask. And I hope it's playing in your mind right now. Now, whilst you have that thought in your mind, let me fast forward and share something with you. There are a lot of myths around financial freedom. But I like to start by saying this: it's not what you think. It's quite different to what you've been taught or what you believe. Let me share what a typical day for me looks like. I wake up in the morning and I do some writing. I'm an author. I've authored 5 books. 4 of them are available on Amazon. My 5th book is out in probably 2 or 3 weeks. I wake up in the morning, and because my mindset is still very malleable and soft, and I still have some insights having rested from the night before, I sit down and I put ink to paper. I write for a few hours, and then I have breakfast. Once I've had breakfast, I read. I have a passion for reading and continuous learning, so I read. I read for a few hours, then I have a mid or late breakfast again. When I'm done with that, I do some yoga, stretch, and let the blood flow through my body. And after about an hour of doing yoga, I have lunch, an early lunch. Once I'm done having the lunch, I exercise. Once that is completed, I do some work, some business. I check up for about an hour. I check in with my various partners. I check in with my emails. And that's it. That's it done. Next, I sit down and I talk to you. I walk into my studio and I share my thoughts with you, which is the most exciting part of my day, the ability to share some of my ideas and thoughts and experiences with you, which is so much fun. That is not work. This is me just having a great time. Once I'm done with all of that, I have some lunch. Next, I listen to some music, and then I'm ready for the evening. For the evening, I either go to the spa, sit in a sauna or in a steam room, or I go swimming, and I just chill. On days I don't feel like doing that, I go dancing. I dance for a few hours, and I hang out and I chill. On days when I don't feel like doing that, maybe I go for a workout. On a day when I don't feel like working out, maybe I go do some martial arts. I get punched in the face, I give some love as well, and I go home. When I arrive back at home, I have dinner, spend some time with my loved ones, and then I go on social media, I check up on some emails, I send some messages to my friends and my community and my tribe, and I'm ready to call it a day. Now, that is a typical day for me. What would your typical day be like? What would you do? What time would you wake up? What would you do when you wake up? Who would you be with? Who would you spend it with? Have you designed your perfect day? Now, I ask you that question simply because I am financially free today, simply because I chose. I started by asking myself these same questions. What would I do if money were no object? How would I really want to spend my life? I retired at the age of 33. Actually, I retired on the same year, within a two-month period, with my father. My father was 65, and I was 33. So technically, I had bought myself back 32 years. And that time gave me a great opportunity to reflect on my past, but also to decide how my future was going to be. You see, history is being made every day, but history is also being written. You see, the latter part of your life has not been decided yet. You can write how the story ends. And that is what I did in my life. And that is the invitation I want to extend to you today. Decide how you want to live. Let me take you a step back now. Now I've painted a picture of the future, a little bit of my future, a little bit for you. Let me take you a step back. Because in your mind, you might be asking, this sounds too good to be true. That's okay. Everyone is entitled to his or her opinion. But I would challenge you by saying this. Rather than ask yourself that disempowering question, why don't you replace it with an empowering question, such as, how did you do it? You see, because the quality of our lives is shaped by the quality of the questions we ask. There is really no mystery in life. All of the secrets to living well, all of the secrets to health, good health, happiness, joy, success, prosperity, love, patience, purpose, are all hidden in questions. Life has hidden all the answers in a question. Now you and I have to simply ask the right question, and just by asking the right question, the answers are released. So rather than ask a disempowering question, why don't you ask the question, how did he do it? And how did he achieve what he's achieved? And how can I replicate the same level of success? You see, your future has not been completely destined. Life does not happen by chance. It happens by choice. You get to choose how your story ends by choice. Now, the first thing I want to share with you, if this is of interest to you. Now, I believe that everyone has a responsibility to be financially free. Why do I say that? Now, money is not everything. Yes, and I've heard that so many times. However, money is simply a means. It provides you with leverage. It enables you to create the environment where you can start to live the extraordinary life. And I define the extraordinary life as simply you living your life according to your standards. You choosing how you want to spend your life. If you want to spend it with loved ones, then you do that. If you want to spend it working, then you do that. But it's life on your terms. And I think it's worth the investment. Now, let me say something to you so you understand. I was only able to achieve financial freedom within 8 years because I followed a plan. I had a desire, I had the passion, I had the dream, I had the goals. But you see, the difference between your dreams and achievements are a number of steps. You need sacrifice, you need discipline, you need persistence, you need effort, you need consistency, and you need patience. But all of that can only be fully activated and applied in the right way if there is a plan. You see, your dreams have to be converted to goals. Your goals have to now be converted to what I call a plan. From that plan, you can develop a strategy. With a strategy in place, you can execute. And if you are patient, if you're willing to work hard, if you're diligent, if you put in the sacrifices that are necessary, you put in the effort, then it's almost guaranteed. It's almost infallible. If you follow the principles, you will get the results. You see, success is like a science. You can predict success with accuracy, the same way you can predict failure with accuracy. If you want to be financially free, your most important task, number one, first of all, is to study success. If you want to be wealthy, study wealth. If you want to be happy, maybe you don't care about money, maybe you don't care about wealth, but if you want to be happy, study happiness. If you want to find your purpose, study purpose. If you want to find joy, study joy. You see, that one of the most important things I learned when I arrived in London, England, was that success leaves behind clues. That was one of the most radical transformations in my head. You see, I had arrived in this country as a poor African boy. I hadn't been exposed to all of this knowledge and all of this information. But when I heard that statement from someone who was a mentor, it awakened something in me, and I've never let that go. I heard the words, success leaves behind clues. And so I did something. I asked myself a question. How do things work? And that is the challenge I want to pass on to you today. One of the most important things you have to do is ask yourself a question. How do things work? And once you've asked that question, the next question you must ask is, now who is living the life I want to live? Who is doing what I want to do? Who is achieving in the area that I want to achieve in? And once you have that, you already have a blueprint that you can replicate. Your responsibility then next is this. Model, model, model. Find the people who are doing what you want and have the life that you want and model them. Model their beliefs, model their behaviors, model their habits, model their lifestyle, model their actions and activities. Because if you can follow the same recipe, you will get the same results. It's a science. It's not based on luck. It's not based on chance. I don't believe much in what we call luck. I think it's too shallow to think of luck. You have to be the right person at the right time, in the right place. Luck for me is simply wasting your God-given ability and potential. You can create anything you want. You get to create your own luck. You don't wait for good luck. You are good luck. You see, greatness is in you. You don't need luck. And so let me conclude by saying this. You can have any life you want. You just have to choose. You can have any future you want. You simply have to believe that it's possible. You have to believe that your future holds the secret to your joy and happiness. And you must have an obsession for making that a reality. If you don't, you can forget it. And so I want to wish you the best of luck. And I hope that your dreams and your desires become a reality. God bless.